Hello and good morning to all of my virgins and simps. It's your boy, the godgamer Harieth. And you know what? It's Friday! And you know what that means? It's time for Fridays with Vivamax Bold Review. And today we are about to review Selina's Gold, which is starring Angeli Khang, Gold Aceron, and J Manalo, and also starring Asia Costa, Gwen Garcy, and many more. So without any further ado, we are about to hit the monetization goal. We just hit the watch hour, so I'm just going to apply for monetization, and I hope you're all there to support me. I will file my application on the 31st of October. We are calling it the exclusive video monetization or the EVM. Ngayon, bago lahat, so patayin muna natin ang music. Tapos, hayaan natin na for 30 seconds mag-like and subscribe tayo sa channel na to. Like nyo yung video, hit that bell icon for more bold review dito sa ating channel. So, ayun. So, babag na rin pala ang Dota sa Sabado. Salamat. We are going to review Selina's Gold, and then Sunday we are going to be reviewing Secrets of an Info, and we're also going to be reviewing the International. It's a long weekend, so enjoy natin. Okay, wag na natin ano pa, wag natin pigilan pa, wag natin patagalin pa. Tara, review na natin. So this is the review of Selina's Gold, directed by what's his name? Let's see, Mac Arthur Alejandre. He is also the director of Silip sa Apoy. So if you remember Silip sa Apoy, that also stars Angeli Khang. Po, and who was Angeli Khang? Ah, Sid Lucero. So Selina's Gold is set in World War II. It's actually set in the 1940s, 1942 to be exact. So this further explains yung sa mga trailer bakit siya ay... Ayun, parang yung makaluma yung mga lengguwahe. I mean, this movie has a trailer infamous for Khang spilling milk over her chest. And then Jay Manalo just stared at it like he is in a trance or something. So, sinusundan natin dito ang kwento ng karakter ni Angeli Khang, si Selina. Si Selina ay anak ni Soliman Cruz. Hindi ko alam yung pangalan niya eh. Basta anak siya ni Soliman Cruz. So pinamigay siya ni Soliman Cruz kay J Manalo, who is named here as Ka-Tiago or Kapitan Tiago or Tiago for short. So si Tiago isang goldsmith siya. Isa siyang wealthy goldsmith dun sa bayan. And yeah, he is also known sa mga tao na inuutangan siya ng mga tao. Ngayon, kung walang may pambayad na utang yung mga nangungutang kay Tiago, ang pinababayad nila ay yung kanilang mga anak. So the case in point, si Cora played by Asia Costa, which is the previous payment before the arrival of Selina. So yung beginning nito, set in 1942, hinahatak ni Soliman Cruz si Selina patungo sa bahay ni Tiago. So may ilog, gubat pa ata eh, para marupok yung daan. Kasi yun nga, sa probinsya to. And parang liblib yung daanan pa. Hindi sila sa highway dumaan basta. Mas daladala niya, umiiyak, kumakagulgol sa iyak itong si Selina. Nang siya ay isinumite sa close ni Tiago. Now, Tiago has a servant boy, isang bulag na kung ang pangalan natin ay Domeng. Siya ay ginagampanan ni Gold Aceron. Last time you saw Gold, it was Scorpion Knights 3. Gold is also featured in Secrets of a Nympho. So, si Domeng ay isang bulag na servant boy, slave ni Tiago. Kasi yung mga panahon na uso yung mga slave eh. So, we have to deal with that fact na may slavery concept dito sa pelikula na to. It's not set in the present time, it's set in the 40s. So, I guess it makakalampas siya. I don't know. Yun. So, yun. That is mainly the plot point. So, ano nangyari dito? Para natuto mag-adapt si Selina para hindi masiraan ng bait. Kasi si Cora, yung babaeng nauna sa kanya, nasiraan ng bait. So, kailangan lang mag-adapt ni Selina sa malis ni Tiago sa pang-araw-araw. And she did that convincingly. Convincingly na parang she played the role as a lover to Tiago, kaya hindi siya pinagmalupitan. She is more proactive as a girl person ni Tiago kaysa sa mga nauna niya. And alam natin, based on the backstory na kwentuhan ni Domeng, si Cora talagang reluctant siya na maging servant ni Tiago, maging slave ni Tiago. Kaya, ayun, si Cora pinagmalupitan. But it seems that Selina is a thinking person, kaya naging proactive siya. So, imbes na si Tiago yung mag-una sa feelings niya, si Selina yung nanguna sa feelings para manipulahin si Tiago. And this also leads to discovering the whereabouts of Tiago's treasures. Yung mga currency dito, highlight talaga ng 1940s. Kasi alam mo yung mga barya, malalaki yung halaga. So, meron dito umihingi ng konsuelo yung nanay ni Cora kay Tiago after, yun nga, pinagmaltratuhan ang anak niya. Nanghingin tuloy siya ng dispensa. At yung pinambayad is coins. Kapalit rin nung sinanglang kwintas. Diba? So, we see the monetary value dito. 1940s. Hindi ito magiging maganda pagdating ng mga Hapon. Kasi magiging mawawala ng value yung peso ng Mickey Mouse money, diba? But this is prior to the surrender of the Philippines to Japan. It is hinted by an air raid of the Japanese forces by covering the area with leaflets. So it's a propaganda. Ngayon, meron ditong eksena dito na si Selina saka si Domeng, they get to know each other behind Tiago's back. And Selina is the first person to show sympathy to Domeng. And this led to Domeng feeling a little bit in the puberty side. Nalaman natin na si Domeng is a former thief na parang may masamang ginawa kay Tiago. And the punishment is Domeng caused Domeng an eye for his eyesight for that. He got branded by melted iron para mabulag si Domeng. And yes, si Domeng has been blind ever since. Now, yung mga activities ni Tiago saka ni Selina dito, they very gratuitous. Meron ditong sa putik ginawa, meron dito nga yung infamous na gatas, meron dito nga yung hinamoy yung ganun. Yeah, it's a gratuitous scenes dito sa puntong ito. Because Selina has to make a point na seryoso siya kay Tiago para hindi siya abusuhin. On the opposite of that, when Selina and Domeng developed feelings and they started to have a intimate relationship, it's much more tamed. Unlike what you see in Gold sa Scorpionites, it's a much more tame outlook. Ang maganda dito, bulag nga si Domeng, diba? Sinututor ni Selina si Domeng paano makipagtalik. And yun. So, yeah, that's the whole point of the story. The survival of Selina in the hands of Tiago. And she made it pretty she made the act pretty convincing. Ngayon, tingin niyo ba si Soliman Cruz, kung sino may karakter niya, as the father of Selina, why is he still hanging out with Tiago? Hindi niya kinakamusta anak niya? Or something? Well, ito yung explanation dyan. So, Tiago went out, have a drink with the folks that include Selina's father. Tiago got so drunk, inatid ng tatay ni Selina si Tiago pa uwi. Dito, nagkaroon na ng plot reveal, ng revelasyon, Wilberto Tolentino, na inassault ni Tiago yung nanay ni Selina that led her to be pregnant, and then yung ang nanay ni Selina, since inassault ni Tiago, she gave birth to Selina. So in a way, Hindi si Soliman Cruz ang tatay ni Selina. So they have no filial relationship, paternal relationship sa isa't isa. Kaya parang okay lang na pinimigay niya si Selina kay Tiago. Ang masaklap dyan, you guess it, tatay ni Selina si Tiago. So, alam niyo yung ano, yung pelikula lang Old Boy, yung ano, pinagtripan yun ng Marvel groups dati kasi, di ba, si Thanos, play, yung artista na gumanap kay Thanos, si Josh Brolin ba yun, and Elizabeth Olsen, si Wanda, nagtalik. And then, in the end, nalaman na anak pala ni Josh Brolin, si Elizabeth Olsen dun sa pelikula na yun. Well, yun yun. So, in shock, umuwi ka agad si, ano, si Tiago. And found out that Domeng and Selina are having an affair. So, during that, Tiago got stabbed by Selina. Selina not knowing the truth that Tiago is her real father. Ngayon, Selina and Domeng escape. They burned the house down. They took all of Tiago's money away. And Selina decided that she and Domeng should split up. Domeng, in despair, keeps looking for Selina till the end. We see people fleeing the province because I assume the Japanese have won the Philippines by that time. So yeah, it's quite a deep story. That's deep lore pagdating sa World War II. And I'm pretty surprised with that. Now, with regards to the tier list. Nakabukas ba yung tier list natin? Tier list. Okay, buksan natin yung tier list. Saglit lang. Okay. So, for the tier list, we are going to rank Selina's gold as what? Ito siya, di ba? Selina's gold, is it all-nighter? We are going to put Selina's gold into the same spot as Scorpion Knight's 3, the Will Bang OK. Okay. Will Bang OK is more of the gratuitous scenes, but what makes it different from Smash? Well, sana kung hindi si Jay Manalo. Kasi si Jay Manalo yung medyo, yung mga eksena ni Kang kay Jay Manalo yung medyo gratuitous. If it's the reversal, si Gold yun mas gratuitous kaysa kay Jay, it would have been a smash. But, let's respect the effort. Let's respect that this could be Kang's last daring scene. Okay, meron silang dalawa ni AJ Raval sa US as her. Pero, let's be honest. She's with AJ Raval. AJ has like the most limitations in all of Vivamax crashes. So this is the ano, most daring possible na pwedeng gawin ni ano ni Kang. So let's go, Will Bang OK for Angeli Khang and Gold Aceron and Jay Manalo in the Selina's Gold. Now yeah, that's it for our review of Selina's Gold. Ngayon, this Sunday, we will be reviewing Secrets of a Nimpo Episode 2. So, we will see Gold Aceron there. I don't know if he will even touch Renescanio. Pero, let's see. And yeah, tune in also to Darna Week 11 review. And we are going to review the International this Monday. So yeah, this is an exciting long weekend, guys. Happy long weekend! This is your boy, the God Gamer, Harieth, signing off. Goodbye and good night. Bang.